have mercy upon me. I didn't know it was wrong. Please forgive me, Lord. I'm sorry, Father. Please forgive me. Lord, have mercy on me. Forgive me, Father. Forgive me.
What happened? Why are you crying?
I'm sorry.
What happened to you? What is wrong? Tell me, please. I've never seen you like this before.
Lord, I'm sorry.
What happened? What happened? Please tell me.
Have mercy on me. Have mercy. Lord. I made a mistake.
Hello? Hello, Pastor Kelvin. Pastor Kelvin, please, we come into our house. Please, it's your friend. It's your friend. Please hurry up. What happened to you? Please. Please, what happened? Tell me. What's wrong with you?
My friend. What is it? Tell us, you are getting us all worried.
I've made a great mistake. I was just telling God to forgive me.
Mistake? What kind of mistake? Please tell us.
I've been running another man's race. I jumped into a ministry God has not called me into.
Ministry? Another man's race?
Yes. The Lord revealed himself to me again. He said he has not called me to be a pastor. He said he has called me to into missions in his vineyard. I love to be a pastor. Maybe because I live with my uncle who is a pastor. Even the Lord was trying to lead me 10 years ago, but I refused to obey. I labored tirelessly day and night for 10 years without benefits. The church members were leaving. I have nothing to show for it. This prompted me to go for 3 days fasting and prayer. In the fasting and prayer today, the Lord showed me a vision where I was walking in another man's field without any benefit for it. I was worried in the same dream. The Lord said he has not called me to be a pastor. He said he has called me to be a missionary.
You mean it was not clear to you that God was calling you as a pastor before you launched your net into the deep? Thank you, God, for your mercy. Thank you, Jesus.
I know my wife loves to be called Pastor Mrs. Gio's wife. She loves all the respect, the glamours. But I have made up my mind. I will go for my calling as a missionary.
That is a very good and wise decision. And the Lord will back you up.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But please, I'm begging you, don't you ever belittle your ministry again. There is no small ministry before God. There is no small character, no small role, but small actors. God has given severally to each and every one according to our ability. Moreover, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 4, verse 2, that it is required of a steward that a man be found faithful. Let us use our God-given talent for God. Let us stay in our ministry. Let's follow the leading of God. Do not let us walk in another man's vineyard. It doesn't have profit. As you do this, as you follow your own ministry and make full proof of your ministry, the Lord will back you up.
Amen.
Now that your husband has decided to follow God's leading, please back him up. Faithful is he that calls. He will surely do it. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your son that you have restored back. Now that he's on the right track, God, please direct him. Help him.
Amen.
Energize him.
Amen.
Everything that he has lost, let him recover.
Amen.
Grant him complete restoration.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name.